Welcome back to Let's Play Disco Elysium Blind. I'm gonna try to ask out Liliane again. Maybe we can warn her about what's happening as well. Before everything goes to hell.
Aye, the sea's gonna calm down soon. I can feel it. The wind is turning southeast. What's on your mind, officer?
I have an option to ask her. Oh, locked, right. I wanted to try to... Oops. I want to see if putting on this coat will help. We found it in the caverns underneath the Feld building last episode.
Aye, the sea's gonna calm down soon.
Nope. Let's go back to... Oh, cloak. I thought that would help. Let's try putting another point into suggestion. This is our cap now for suggestion. I was saying I should try again. With the washerwoman, I can't see where in conversation, but Liliane, you know. Yeah, it should tell you what challenge it is. It just doesn't. All it says is who, where, and what kind of check skill is involved. Hey, kids. Oh, never mind.
Aye, the sea's gonna calm down soon. I can feel it. The wind is turning southeast. What's on your mind, officer?
Wow, it doesn't seem to matter how much we put into it either. Nope. Alcohol makes closeness possible. Let's connect. Alcohol? Connect? I'm not sure I'm following you. There's confusion in her eyes. Of course, you know, this probably isn't going to work because we failed. Unless she likes him that much that even failing is fine. Get hammered with me on a date. Drunk date. It'll be nice, I promise. She bursts out laughing. That's a good impression. You really cracked me up, officer. Now how can I help you? She doesn't even understand you asked her out. Suggestion says, perhaps you're too sober to pull it off right now? Try again later. Do we need a drink? Because I didn't see anything. This is the psyche. Suggestion is under psyche, and we don't have anything. At least I can't see anything that would help with psyche. This helps with physique. Physique. Motorics. Yeah, I don't know. Fail. We tried anyway. Just not a good suggestion type person, I guess. Now, we're at our limit, so unless we find something else that increases it... The music seems very loud. Come on, guys. Oh, it's still at the same setting. Let's put this away. And still want to get through there. Explore that, but I guess that's not something we can explore. And now, unfortunately, we turn the music off, which is not there, but here. Cause it's gonna change to... It was, like, oddly silent. It's gonna change to something that, gets a content ID hit. Could I warn people? I mean... Should I just be warning everybody? People that we don't despise. This guy, maybe?
Oh, look. It's the cop who turned me into a bad person.
Yeah, I feel kind of bad about that, but what can you do? So, apparently there's going to be a war here? I don't know if these people should... Be warned. I mean, definitely Titus. Because these guys are the workers.
The Coppernado is back. What do you want?
I don't have a chance. I don't have a choice to warn him. That's locked. I mean, unless it's hidden in a submenu or something.
Hey, was there something you needed?
Alright, let's go talk to Clashy again. Is that thing always there? Hmm. Classy.
I was just thinking, what a nice day for questions pertaining to a murder investigation.
It's always a nice day for a murder investigation questions. No, I don't have a chance to, I don't have a choice to warn anybody. Now, I don't want to warn Evrart. But I feel like I should do something. Maybe I can talk him out of something. I don't know. Or maybe I can try to take him out. Because if we can prevent a war, you know, what's one man's life versus thousands?
Again, I can't believe this shit.
This is new. Shot and hanged. We found that out after we've talked to him last about this stuff. This person was shot and then made to look like he was hanged. He might have been shot by the people who hanged him. He may have been shot by the person who made it look like he was hanged. The person who we think shot him... Okay. Did I get a chance to say all these? Okay, I'm doing this investigation. It turns out he was shot and hanged. You think he was hanged as a cover-up to hide the shooting? Basically, yes. Okay, well, he corrects his blonde wig. His hair. He corrects his hair. Hey, why am I telling you this? I don't know. Why are you? He gives you an odd look. Oh my god, there's more. He looks at you in disbelief. You want something more. What is it? This person who was shot and hanged, he may have been shot by the person who made it look like he was hanged. A cover-up? Where the author of the cover-up is the perp? Makes sense. I know, right? But what's the motive? You don't have a motive? Then the double cover-up seems too neat. I don't know. Why are you? He gives you an odd look. Well, I didn't ask him that yet. Hangman again. The person who we think shot him, who made it look like he was hanged, that we're looking for, we can't find her. Well, where have you looked for her? We think she may be on the coast. West of here? Though luck. The place is ruined from the bombardment. A lot of places to hide there. Not so much. I figure he might have some insight.
Yes? What is it?
Alright, never mind. Alright. tried warning them. Now we head over to do something with Evrart. I have no idea what. Is this guy with them? I don't like him, he's a racist.
Looking for something, Hunt? Huh? Coming to tell me to fuck off again?
I was thinking about it. I like tell me manana, though. Or call me manana, rather.
Hola, wandering man. How can I help you?
I only have a chance to talk about the hanged man. Maybe I'll have another chance to say something else about what I found. Same as with the my partner there.
Hola, wandering man. How can I help you?
It's nothing. All right. Oh, something new here? A giant ass print on the pillow and a pattern of coffee rings on the armrest. Someone is habitually chilling out next to the radio. Huh. Well, what's her name? Ruby? She likes to do stuff with the radio. Did I do this before? Force yourself to go through the folders? Whatever's hidden here is hidden well, Volition says. Concentration isn't enough. Only a trained accountant with a background in logistics would be able to really make sense of it. However, there is a little handwritten note stuck on the side of the drawer. If I've looked at this stuff before, guys, forgive me. I think I might have. It appears to be a to-do list written in large, uneven capital letters. Remember, Leo. Evrart's shoes, special whirling borscht, water Evrart's plants, sweep office floor, more banners. Alright, this Leo does this stuff. That's his little checklist. All items on the list have been crossed out and the note itself is crumpled. Remember Leo. Oh, it's to Leo. Okay. Look, Kim, a to-do list with list of errands for Evrart. He inspects a note. One of his aides must have left it. Nothing incriminating here. Logic says the special borscht seems a bit odd on the list. Special whirling borscht. Okay. No idea. Alright. Run in here because that was new. See anything going on. Alright. And what's this? To make a call? The machine swallows your coin and seems to be waiting for your next move. This could be... Well, of course I'm going to have to enter more coins, aren't I? Oh, no, I don't. Okay. Let your muscle memory dial a random number. +2 for heard your name. Success. Your fingers run over the dial pad. 005, that's a dialing code for Revachol, 49-52, and a moment of hesitation before entering the final numbers, 993. Okay, so this is a number that I know, but I guess I don't remember whose number it is. Just I've dialed it so much, it's in muscle memory. Calling. Calling. Still calling. Then, a crackle. Someone picks up. They say, Video Revachol, 24-hour video rental. We rent 8 and 10 millimeter film for home use. This is Lemmy. How may I help you? Perception hearing says the voice of a youngster on the other end sounds as enthusiastic as that of a man walking toward the gallows. What is this place? Video Revachol is a 24-hour video rental. We rent 8 and 10mm film for home use. This is Lemmy. No, I mean, what is this place to me? Sir, I don't know. It's a video rental. Maybe you rent videos here? Do you know me? No. Why did I call you? Maybe you called to extend your rental period? Do you need to extend your rental period? My name is Harrier Dubois. Do you have anything on my name? Let me fire up the machine. Keys are being pressed in the background. Dubois, Dubois. Here we are. You haven't rented anything in 5 years, but you still have a copy of Blue Ocean Hell from November 46. Whew, not a fun film, that one. What kind of a film is that? It's not an easy watch, he reads. After the death of his daughter and subsequent divorce, Zimsk immigrant Igidius Washik tries to come to terms with the onset of dementia. He concludes, no wonder no one's been missing it. Still, it would be great if you could return it to us. We're on the corner of Voyager and Main. The call is terminated by the other party. You're left with the discomforting sound of the disconnect tone. Boop. All right. Well, found out another little note about his past. So most likely it's going to be in Jamrock, so we're not going to be going there. At least, I don't think so. Now that we're over here, we can turn the music back on. I do like this theme. Very, like, sounding of intrigue. Alright, should I mess with this thing again? Same as last time. Let's talk to Leo really quick. See if we can ask him about that note, maybe? The Borscht?
Mister, I need to be back to talk with old Leah here. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. It's like Lady Larice said when she opened a bathhouse in the basement of my apartment building. They can only get so far before they're aching to get back. And a lot of folks really did keep coming back.
That's nice. Are you the Leo who wrote the note to make more banners? Oh, yes, yes, he replies excitedly. I leave all kinds of notes for myself. That old head of mine ain't so good for keeping things in no more. I almost forgot about the Borscht. What was that about the Borscht? Oh yes, I've been taking special whirling Borscht to the men every day since the strike started. The little guy chuckles merrily. It's very, very good. Makes a man feel so warm and happy. He shakes his head with a wide smile. I feel like I can take on Mr. Renaudin's boar dogs every time the lunch is done. What do you mean by taking this soup to the men? Is it for striking? Yes, yes, I'm taking it to them. The Borscht keeps them happy and in fighting spirits. Makes you all warm inside. They brew it in the whirling in rags. Oh, dang, this is different. Hold up. Who makes it the whirling? Oh, the whirling's cook. He makes it. Them is always talking with Mr. Manana in that weird language and laughing together. He doesn't speak what we speak. He's from Grodd. Yeah, I haven't been able to actually successfully talk to him. Something is off about this Borscht. I'm gonna look into it. Oh, sure, mister. Sure. The little guy nods. You do that, yes, sir. Composure says he didn't actually understand what you meant, and now he's just nodding along. Alright. Got another task. The special Borscht. Borscht. What's so special about the Borscht the strikers are eating? The cook in the whirling and rags is making it. You can find him in the kitchen. Look into it. Okay. Okay. I don't know what we can do with Evrart, but let's see. I'm not going to get into the drug trade with him and start dealing drugs and stuff and telling him it's awesome. I refuse.
So, the ship has sailed. Did you see it? I know you did. Tell me, what did it look like as it grew smaller and smaller when that mainsail dropped behind the horizon?
He leans toward you.
Did it look like a germ? Did it look like a piece of bacteria?
Inland Empire says you get a sinking feeling. I don't understand. What do you mean? Don't worry, Harry. He does. He nods toward the lieutenant. At least I think he does. Kim says, you wanted us to relay all this information to her. You wanted us, huh? That it's a takeover, that I want a war? He nods forcefully. God, I hope you also told her about the drug trade. They absolutely hate getting their hands dirty with that. You can kill 1 million people, but if you do something the police doesn't like, well then you're out of the yacht club. A vein on his forehead is pulsating. Goodbye, you inhuman... Beep. So this was your plan all along, for me to relay this information to her. Harry, he exhales slowly, I can't see into the future. We are all playing by ear on this planet. I had no idea she'd react so strongly. But you did want me to relay info to her. Well, she's not answering the question. I did. I knew the negotiations would go better with police officers telling her horror stories from inside the harbor. It's scarier this way. Turns out it was a magnificent strategy. I never thought it'd so fundamentally screw her up. So now I know why you've been so forthcoming. No, no, Harry. What we have here is real. We're working men. This here, he taps his chest, then points to you, is real. How did you know she left? Harry, I bugged her cabin. I bugged her whole boat. I had cameras surveying her boat. Hell, I even wanted to bug that thermal cup, but my boys advised against it. Savoir Faire says they must have done it while Joyce was busy questioning the locals. So you've been listening to our conversations this whole time. Not me, personally. He stretches his arms like a discus thrower. I had guys recording and processing this information for me. The Hardy Boys? Hell no, he exclaims. They'd screw it up. They can't do anything right. I mean my real boys. My special task force boys. Where are these boys? Kim says. They sure as hell aren't hanging out in the open with beers in their hands for the cops to question. He bursts out laughing. They're pros, Mr. Katsuragi. You used me. Harry, you made a conscious decision to relay that information to her. You could have kept it for yourself. You used my intellectual curiosity against me. Against you? He's taken aback. Oh, Harry, I'd like to think I used it for you. But she told me a beautiful story about the discovery of the Insulind. Of course she did. Rich people have the best stories about all the interesting things they've done and seen, all the beautiful places they've been to. It's just sentimentalism. She can afford to be sentimental, and she can afford to lose as well. Okay. I have no reason to tell him this. So what's going to happen now? What was always going to happen? We take the harbor, and she screws off to Ozone, uncorks a bottle of wine, calls her partners, and says they need to distance themselves from this nasty business before the big crap spinner splashes everyone. Only difference is, the Union doesn't have to lose 2,000 men to machine gun fire. I have a bad taste in my mouth. You better make sure this ends up saving lives. That it will, Harry. That it will. A sincere smile crosses his face. As to the bad taste, please. You're not a sommelier. Or whatever that is. You're a cop. You knew something. Something big. And you wanted to see what happens when you tell someone. So you told her. Anyone who's ever been close to power will tell you. Inside information is the sweetest thing in the world. It's better than money. Better than that. Money only makes you special for some salesmen. Sex only makes you special for yourself. Information makes you special for all mankind. It's a ticket to history. Right on, Harry. What you did was participate in history. When history calls, you have to pick up. You had no choice. None of us ever do. A hard disco cop like you, I knew you weren't one to resist temptation. Well, hell, man. He's really screwed us up. You know what, Detective? Kim says, I'm going to leave this out of my report, and I suggest you leave it out of yours, too. Heh, he chuckles. Just look at the three of us. The three careless boyaderos. Good times, good times. So what now? Now there's a whole lot of work to do. For me and you. I suppose there was a reason you came here, so let's get to it. What can I help my best friend and comrade with today? Remember the container I asked you about? Turns out there's a mega-rich light-bending guy inside. Mega-rich light-bending guy? My god, how'd that get in there? He's so rich he could get in anywhere. Damn it to hell, Harry. He slams his fist on the table. I specifically told my guys to check all the containers for mega-rich light-bending guys. Seriously? Kim, tell him he was there. There was a guy in a container, Lieutenant says slowly, but he didn't bend any light. That was in the detective's head. Honestly, guys, we might be moving a spot of drugs through this harbor, but I won't be caught transporting light-bending mega-rich. He shakes his head. I have reputation to protect. Kimmy stock tips. This honored by the presence of this magus. Oh, true. The mega-rich are people, too. He was a nice man. Gave me stock tips. No, they're not. He smiles brightly. They're vermin, and one just found a way inside my container. Soon he'll bring the others. All three of them. Thank you for telling me. I'll see to this immediately. So there's exactly two more? He bursts out laughing. I shudder to think what you're going to tell me next, Harry. Okay, he's just messing with us. Drama says, not for one second did he believe there's an actual mega-rich person somewhere in this container town. Look, my gun. My, he lets out an appreciative whistle. She's quite the looker, Harry. You can't imagine how pleased I am the two of you are reunited. Tell me, was it difficult to convince? The big man pauses to tap on his chin. The pigs to give it up? Not at all. I knew you could handle it. I know my special policeman. Anyway, I'm glad you're all right and armed again, Harry. Now, what can Evrart Claire do for you? I'm looking into your shady brew. I don't know what that means, Harry. Shady brew? There are so many moving parts of my operation, I can't keep track of them all. You know what? Don't even tell me. Whatever it is, do it. Surprise me, he reconsiders. Just one thing. If you can, make it even shadier. Drama says, he sincerely has no idea what you were talking about. He doesn't care either. All right. We're then running back to the Whirling and Rags to find out about this borscht. From a cook that we cannot understand. And maybe that leads to something else, but for now, we don't have anything to do until we get back to the cavern and cross the path of no return. See a reason to talk to that guy. I'll try to go around that way. Okay, now we turn the music off again. Okay. And Joyce said we have to look out for people. But I don't have a chance to warn anybody. I'm not going to talk to this guy. He's one of the mercenaries. That would be mucho dangeroso. Guess I literally just made that word up. Now this song, haven't heard for a while, and this one doesn't get hit with content ID claims. This guy, we cannot understand this guy. The man ponders his cooking utensils and gives you a little nod, acknowledging your presence. Leo said you're friends with Manana, is that true? The mention of Manana gets his attention. He smiles and delivers a whole slew of unfamiliar words and lively gestures. Then he falls silent again. Unfamiliar words? Yeah, he does talk. Empathy says they're friends. What is in that borscht you're making there? The man says a couple of sentences in that strange language of his and then seems to wait for you to speak. Rhetoric says, I'm pretty sure he asked you a question. Conceptualization says, he doesn't know your language. You can just say something cool in return. Mercury rising. The man looks at you, then at his soup. His face lightens up. He picks up a bottle from the shelf. Bars need more vodka? Kim says, okay, so it's vodka that keeps the men happy and in good spirits, he nods. Clever move by the union. Electrochemistry says, of course, vodka. Now that makes it very, very special borscht indeed. Turn it up and then ask for some yourself. Logic says, turning it up seems like a dangerous idea, honestly. The place is a powder keg. No, no vodka. Turn your fingers counterclockwise. Cut it. Task complete. The cook gives you a long, disappointed look, then turns the stove off and seems to wait for you to speak. Alright, well that's done. Saturday. Yeah. Alright, well I tell them to take the vodka out. Maybe that will lessen their morale. They'll stop striking? I don't know.
Hey, was there something you needed?
Alright, never mind. Okay, I literally don't know what else to do. Okay. So we're going back to the cave next episode. Let me ask him.
The Copper NATO is back. What do you want?
I don't have any choice to say, tell him anything about the borscht. Alright, never mind. Yeah, gonna call it an episode here, so we're back to, unless something happens along the way, we're going to head back to the cave underneath the, what do you call it? The Feld building. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.